TV, you're joining myself, Bren, and Sim for the conclusion of the final qualifying cup for DreamHack Summer. And it's going to be LEGO, which most people probably would have expected going into this. And on the other side of it, it's going to be the Russian mixed team Serpents in this grand final. Bit of an upset, really. Firstly, beating Happy Farmers, then beating DD5 Abs, the team that narrowly missed out in the Prem playoffs. And taking it all the way to the final for a chance at €1,000 and an invitation to DreamHack Summer.
It's interesting, to say the least. Interesting. Part of me wishes that a Russian mixed team at the last minute shouldn't really be getting this far in a tournament. But at the end of the day, there's only so many top teams left, Publiclear and LEGO being two of them. So maybe if Publiclear met up with Serpents, we might see a different story. But ultimately, I'm thinking between these two teams, LEGO most likely are the best equipped to deal with that Kensi sniper.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, part of it is going to be that it's just kind of unpredictable, because we saw like earlier, like when comfortably spanked, like Tom was neutralizing Atomic a lot on the flank because he knew what to expect. Whereas with this Russian team, because a lot of them don't play and they don't play as a team full time, it makes the whole thing a lot more unpredictable. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be a bit of a coin toss almost, as we do see the bans and picks coming in, and it looks like Snakewater and Viaducts are going to be the first two maps. Doesn't tell me which way round, but I guess I'd hazard LEGO picked Viaducts. No, the Russians. Yeah, the Russians would have picked Viaducts. I think I put Kenzie on Sniper. We talked about this a little bit before we left for the break, and just how dangerous Kenzie can be on that Sniper, and LEGO are going to have to work really hard to stop him on Viaduct, because it's such a good map for Sniper. So it'll be interesting to see whether they want to put Zen or Eyes on as like a straight counter against Kenzie on Sniper, or if they just want to try and play a more sort of hyper-aggressive role to counter it.
It is going to be interesting to see. I cannot think, like, is anyone on LEGO like decent against Sniper? Because it can be it's going to actually wreck them if they don't have a good way to deal with him.
I think if anyone, it would be Zen, but yeah. I think they would opt to counter the Sniper indirectly rather than go toe to toe with him.
Right. Okay.
And it looks like, so the other map's going to be Snakewater. Again, a map with some good sniper lines that might favour Kenzie. But the third map is going to be Granary. And we've seen LEGO particularly good at Granary, Zen and Josh both strong on it. So I feel like if it does go to a third map, LEGO are going to clinch it. Mm-hmm. So in terms of Serpents wanting to win the prize money and the invite, it's going to have to be these first two maps. And it is going to be Viaduct first. So this could be a tough opening test for LEGO in this best of three.
I'll be completely honest. Like, I'm 100% expecting Serpent to just clinch this just because of that Kensi sniper pickup. If they don't have an answer to it, it's going to be really tough. The important thing is to basically, I suppose, they should just play their own game. If they can win the map, that's going to be excellent for them, because it wasn't their pick. However, if they do lose it, I wouldn't be too surprised, because I'd imagine that they are actually really solid on Viaduct on their own pick. So I don't know. We're getting into the game now, though. I believe the players are just starting to join.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting for sure. But I think what will be also is how they complement Kenzie on Sniper. Whether Shadowburn continues to play Soldier
on his preferred
class, but he's also, I think it's happened once or twice before in Viaduct, where he's swapped out to Scout, and he's quite dangerous on Scout as well. Really good DM. So if they want to make that switch up and the lineup that was originally made by Immunity, was it at I-49?
Nine.
Nine, yeah, I want to say. Yeah. Where they'd swap Yuki, their pocket, off onto onto Scout. And yeah, run two Scouts because of how strong Scout is on Viaducts, and just give up on the Soldier class. So that'll be, I think that probably would be their best option, depending on how comfortable Shadowburn feels on Scout, you know, after not playing the game as much.
It's definitely going to be interesting. If Shadowburn can go to Scout, I think that might be their one saving grace that LEGO have, is that they don't have Shadowburn. I haven't seen him play Scout. Soldier is his strongest role. I don't know if he can play it to a reasonable level, especially after taking such a long break from TF2 as well. Who knows? Who knows, honestly? Haffy Cool is playing for LEGO.
Haffy Cool joined as coach on the LEGO team. So I presume he will leave the server. No coaches allowed.
Got Dr. Phil, Zen, Sorex. Is somebody nicking as Nowz? Or was that an actual player that I'm supposed to know of?
Sorry, where are you looking? Oh, on the LEGO roster. Yeah. I think that's Izon, if I remember correctly.
Okay.
If I remember my alias school.
Coaching is fine, by the way, as well. So teams are allowed to have a coach, which could be a very strong tool. It's not really been mentioned much, because I believe it's only just been allowed in this tournament, which is the final DreamHack tournament. But you can have a seventh man to basically join, only spectate from your team's perspective. And if you don't have a designated main caller in somebody's teams, that can be a saving grace, to be honest. Like, because having someone on the outside perspective, I guess in some ways it is one more person to clutter the comms, but having someone who can literally just switch between all these players at one time can be an absolute incredible saving grace. And we do see, I think, yeah, Haffy Cool is going to be switching to spec fairly shortly. I think it might automatically put into spec, but yeah.
But it is Haffy Cool, so it's probably not going to be too much right, help. Yeah. So, coach in theory can be a big addition to your team, but not if it's Haffy Cool.
Haffy Cool says in a chat, coach is allowed, idiot caster. Shaking my head, so I hope that was directed at you.
Presumably. You can spec if you want Haffy, but you won't make a difference.
I don't know if that is the real Haffy Cool. Someone's been fake Haffying. Have you seen him? Like, they've registered a Twitch account with the name Haffy Cool, but instead of an L, it's an I at the end, and he's just been, like, shit-talking people in different Twitch chats and getting banned. Nice. I'm pretty sure that's identity theft in a few countries.
Yeah,
but
that's fraud right there.
Yeah.
Twitch chat fraud. And it looks like Kenzie's warming up on Sniper as well, so fully what we expected here. But on the other hand, I imagine LEGO will be expecting it as well, so it won't come as a surprise.
No, it shouldn't anyway.
Yeah,
I see Zen as well on Sniper. Mm. Now,
the one thing LEGO do have is they know exactly what is coming.
The impeding storm. All those other teams just did not know. Yeah. It's going to be interesting. I think, you know, when you're getting into these grand finals, €1,000 on the line as well, it's everything to play for, to be honest. You're playing for a lot of money. You're playing for that coveted spot that LEGO have been after for so long. I genuinely think if LEGO take this first map, this game's in the bag for them, this grand final's in the bag, because this is, as you mentioned, this is the true test. This is to see who, you know, if they can beat them on their own home ground with Kenzie on Sniper, they're pretty much unstoppable.
Yeah, I believe we're going live pretty soon. So where do you think this is going to go, Brendan, this opening map? Who's going to win? Who's going to come out themselves?
Honestly, I'm expecting a very close game. It's going to be hard to call now that I know that Zen might be able to do something, but actually, he's gone back to Soldier. It's going to be tough to call. It's going to be really tough. I'm going to give it to Serpents in the end. I'm going to think it's going to be an absolute slobber knocker, I believe is the term used before. Slobber knocker.
All right, then.
I can't remember who said that, but I just laughed when it was said in the cast.
And it's going to be Kenzie going on to the top of this China area on Balcony straight away. No team really wanted to commit. Izon trying to get aggressive, but he's being denied. Unlimited, actually, the first frag. But a lot of point presence for LEGO coming out. Sorix trying to pressure him back. Kenzie yet to find an angle on anyone so far. Dr. Phil's going to go down as well. There's a soldier behind Dicker, but Nesh gets there just in the nick of time to save his medic. He's going to go down. Shadowburn and Shayu chasing Sorix. They are going to force him out. Shadowburn even going to claim that frag. And is that a double black box coming out from the Russian soldiers?
They have played it in the past, haven't they? They are fans of the Black Box on Viaduct. It can be quite strong, but we do see, yeah, they're only running the one scout, which is very interesting. But LEGO in a bit of a hard situation now. They don't really have an answer just yet to the sniper. They have actually off-classed Izon, I believe, the sniper. So we are going to see if he can make any magic happen. But ultimately, they are holding with this uber disadvantage. They are just pushing. Oh, actually, Kenzie actually goes down there to Izon. That's a cheeky little pick. And here we go. This is the play going to be happening. Uber's going to be popped out straight away. And if the LEGO guys, if they kite this, they're in a very nice position. Dr. Phil is going to pay with his life. But look at this big bomb straight away. I don't know who the spaceman is, but he's getting frags. And already sets up the kill onto Dicker. So that's no medic now onto the side of the Russians. And now it's just literally Shadowburn trying to pick up these stragglers behind the enemy line on that cliff area. Zen trying to take that 1v1. Diz does actually do very well against Shayu. But ultimately, they're going to have this uber advantage to work off CX.
Yeah, Josh for Spaceman there forces Dicker into Izon's sightlines, gets the body shot kit. And now they've got this full uber to walk in with because Condom just stayed really passive in that whole sort of attempt onto the point. Now they're going to try and take this over without using it. Josh taking the forward ground. Kenzie's still got an angle though, so we do have to be careful. The Russians do want to pressure him back here, but Izon again takes down the only scout on the Russian team. That's going to give a lot less fragging power, and the Russians just can't seem to get past this cliff. They're just pinned back in there, and Izon certainly doing a good job on sniper so far, and we see Zen swapping off the scout to complement it. Now,
yeah.
Immunity. Like class configuration like we were looking at.
I like it a lot. Kenzie actually does manage to pick up the sniper there, so Izon is going to go down and they're not going to have that sightline advantage and that pressure, that early pressure that they were having. And this is where the slow cap comes out. Uber's going to be popped out now. They need to make sure they don't drop any players at all on the back lines. Shayu's going to be escaping with his life, and here we go. It's Shadowburn forced to absolutely no health. A minute amount. Unlimited power has been jumped by Josh. Beautiful little juggle there. Completely cleans him up. The old 1-2, and he's gone down. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Shayu actually drops Zen as well, if I think pressured a little bit too far forward. And here we go, the Russians, they're only just recapping. Shadowburn's taking a lot of spam already, going to be having to get healed all the way back. A couple of big arrows coming out from the side of LEGO, but ultimately, they're holding on. They've still got this cap time.
Yeah, they do have Uber right now, the Russians. I'm just trying to move forward now. Lots of stickies, and Dick is actually going to pop onto Shadowburn. He's going to try and go deep, searching, but all he can find is Sorex, and he can't even close that frag off. The Russians have traded Uber for the point right now, but LEGO are starting to circle. Josh is coming from behind and got one frag onto the sniper, and that's going to allow his team to come forward. Then comes Shadowburn from behind!
Oh my god!
He gets two! Shayu combines and they just absolutely melt the rest of the LEGO team. It's only Izon left, but he's getting pressured out. Shayu and Shadowburn combine. That was like four or five frags between the Russian soldier duo.
Wow.
And they absolutely crush him there at the perfect time as well. Condom was so close to getting into that Uber as well, and that would have been curtains for the point.
That was actually a really beautiful piece of TF2 there. They just completely collapsed on them and played that at the exact right time. Kenzie, still on sniper now, just going to be watching up from that cliff area. And now we've dropped below the minute point there. The time is ticking down. The Russians are still in control right now. Look at Josh, big bomb forward, actually has picked up the sniper. And that's going to be a lovely pick. Shayu eats so much damage. He's actually eaten a lot of pills now. And Dr. Phil doing his darndest to keep him off the point. He's on a sliver of HP. Uber going to be popped out by the Russians now. He's already on 50%. Condom still does not have it. So they just need to kite this for days. Eyes on sniper. Going to be trying to make some plays happen. Shayu deep on him. Actually picks up him as well. Shadowburn and Shayu on a 5k and 4k respectively. And the Russians just really holding this game in control.
If only Happy Cool could coach better.
Yeah, it's all Happy Cool's fault.
They're coming out right now, but Josh is going to be domed straight away by Kenzie. Shadowburn pressure him back, and Kenzie gets another one, and it's so LEGO just can't get forward. They're on 89%.
Oh, wow.
They just have
another
to save
one.
Condom now.
3k. Can he make it a 4k? I'm not sure, but 3 seconds on the clock. This is GG for the first round at least. Still remember, we gotta be playing a few more rounds of this game before it's over just yet. But what a showing by the Russians, honestly. LEGO, they need to sort something out, otherwise it's gonna be slipping away from their grasp.
Yeah, really comfortable as well, like time-wise. It was still like what, 1:40 or over left on the point for LEGO. Odd choice, I think, to compete so directly with Kenzie, and it didn't work out. When you can see this time they're running the cookie cutter lineup, Izon taking that high ground straight away. But you just have to avoid the sideline of Kenzie right now. And it looks like Josh is actually going to go deep straight onto Kenzie.
Oh,
takes him down. No problem.
Oh my goodness, look at him go! He's already on Dicta, the entire team is there, beating him to death. Nesh actually destroys Josh with his Boston Basher. Izon is going to try and escape with a sliver of HP, he's on 5 health, trying to escape behind enemy lines, and he picks up Shadowburn as he's running around. Zen did fall, however, but ultimately, Lego, what a showing!
Yeah, and that bomb from Josh was just a catalyst, and Lego all moved across the point to support him. Takes down the sniper threat straight away, and also turns over heads, allowing so much damage to be done by the rest of his team. But they do lose Condom in the midst of it, so it will be equal Ubers, meaning they can basically challenge this point directly straight away. And we see Kenzie back on that sniper, trying to find an angle, but Josh has been on top of him so far. And I imagine he's looking to do that again, playing on that flank area. As the Serpents start to cap the point, Dr. Phil's putting out a lot of damage. It's a single soldier trade though, as Zen's actually on direct hit, takes down Shayu. Izon's gone deep, but Nesh will clean him up. There's not a lot of firepower though, they really could do with Kenzie to get a
Dr. Phil! Oh my god.
He put out so much damage, but Nesh is actually one he finds for frag. He's now back with Zen on that direct hit, I presume trying to counter the Cypher and just spam him down.
That's what I thought, yeah.
But, odd choice. And Kenzie survives the whole thing, and even without Kenzie actually getting the frags, just the threat of him seems to just keep the Lego on edge. Condom always has to be thinking about his positioning and what sight lines he opens himself out to. As yeah. We see the Uber actually come out, popping it early. The counter Uber's going to come out onto that sniper. Dicker's going to flash everyone and try to keep him alive. But they're trying to focus Shadowburn on the flank as well, but it's not working out. Direct hit!
Oh my god.
He goes down eventually, but not before getting a 2k, and that should open up this point for his team.
Look at Sorek's D behind enemy lines. Here we go, Unlimited Power is going to be the one to fall in this fight. Still kicking off. I think the Russians, they do not want to give it up just yet. Shadowburn taking a fight to them, but what's this? On the back lines, eyes on. He's missing all of his shot onto Dicker. Please kill Dicker, please! Oh my god, yes, he died! How did Dicker get out alive? 3 HP and he beefs that? That shouldn't be happening. And Kenzie picks up the headshot to Josh.
Now Condom just has to fall back, desperately trying to meet up with his team right there. And what an important beef that was from Izon. Like, Dicker surviving in that situation keeps the Ubers just about even. And Kenzie is just doming these soldiers, stopping any kind of momentum they can have. We see Condom's going to rotate all the way around to Cliff while he gets that Uber up. Equal Ubers now, but the Russian takes a full minute off the time about right about
this
here.
This is rough. Look at this big bomb forward by Josh. Can he pick up Kenzie? One rocket, two rockets. Cleaned up with ease. And here comes the Uber. Eventually going to be popped out onto both these teams as the Russians are looking to contest them. And contest them they will. But at what cost? Lego already picking up the 3k. Kenzie, Shayu and Nesh falling. Izon, however, does fall to the side of Unlimited with a beautiful little pill from that man. And Shadowburn going to be doing his darndest from that China area. Not doing much, however. Sorex is putting a lot of territory, a lot of pressure. And eventually Lego going to be the winners of that cap point.
Yeah, Sorek's chasing down that low medic right at the end as well, just seals the deal, going to put Lego in a great position. Staying ahead of the time right now, only a minute and a half left, and I imagine the Russians are going to come out for more of a suicide sale play, but Condom's all the way back on that cliff, both scouts with him as well.
Oh, so instead
they're just going to bait the point and play around their knife, makes it so difficult for Lego. Shayu's going to pressure him as well, he's super low, but he will get out, but Serpents just take it straight back off them. And they're playing around the sniper perfectly there, just rather than going deep to try and get Condom, they're just playing the point and forcing Lego to commit to no sightlines Kenzie's watching.
This is interesting now because the clock is still clicking down, and here we go, Josh already behind enemy lines once again, trying to do the same trick once again. Uber's going to be popped out by Lego actually, but they've dropped so many players on the back lines. The Russians absolutely creating mayhem, and Shadowburn, Dr. Phil actually picks up a beautiful little pill by cleaning him up, but at what cost? They've dropped so many players, they're only just getting respawns, and the Russians are still in control of this point, Commander X.
Yeah, they hold on, there's 60 seconds left, but the Russians are depleted. No Demon Man and no Shadowburn in for another few seconds. I mean, they do have a sniper, meaning they could be open to a suicide wave here. And Dicker's not standing particularly defensively on 90%. So if Lego move quickly, they have an opening here they can get onto Dicker. Shayu is now with them now as well. In comes Josh, first of all, trying to focus down that soldier. Shadowburn's going to help his teammate out, though. But it's really messy, but Kenzie, in all of this, finds the first frag, and the Uber comes forward, Shayu leading the charge, combines with Nesh, they're trying to focus down Zen. Surely they'll eventually get Zen, but it has created enough distraction for Condom to get out. And because Condom survives, it's basically a suicide wave and has given them a big Uber advantage. But with only 17 seconds left, they're going to have to go before this Uber is ready. 70% on Condom right now.
This is so tough. They need to make a play. They need to make it now. Josh with a big bump forward. Getting completely denied by Nesh. Just misses the air shot. And Kenzie's the one to finish him up. At the same time, Shayu is the one to fall. 3 seconds left on the clock. They need to get some cap time. And they're already doing it. Both scouts running across the point now. They need to make something happen. Kenzie doing his darnest. Uber finally coming up by Condom. And a lot of spam coming in. Raining artillery from above. Sorek's the one to pick up that frag onto Kenzie. But is it what they really wanted? As Dicker, he has this Uber to work with now. They need to make a play and they need it now. As Lego, they've got to hold on for a minute. A whole minute, Commander X.
Yeah, they literally can't lose the point in this scenario. And the Russians have a full Uber to play with. They still have... they actually swap Kenzie back off to scout. They're just going full aggression on this. As they start to come in, Shire leading the charge. Dicker trying to avoid it. They Uber nice and early. They just need to get presence on that point. Nesh is going to start the cap. They've not really found much damage off Axe, though. Shire is deep all over Condom. Condom has to commit to this. But all the Lego players are coming in. It's just a
good
DM
God.
Fest. The soldiers are doing so much, and they cap it out, though. And it was always going to be tough for Lego. They had to commit to that, but... Yeah. Serpent's just ruthless, find all the frags, and really nice. I like the early Uber there in that situation where they just need to get the cap, keep everyone healthy, and just take the 6v6 DM fight.
Here we go, this is it. This is basically LEGO's last stand now. If they lose this, they're going to lose the first map in a very rapid takeover, very rapid fashion, as we do see it's already kicking off. A lot of spam being exchanged by both these teams. Kenzie on that China snipe sightline, doing a lot of work. Josh with a big bump forward, and he picks up Dicker. What an unbelievable frag by that man. Zen's going to try and defend his medic at the end of the day, but Shadowburn got there first, as Condom is the one to fall in the end. Shadowburn just trying to take this 1v1 against Zen, and he's the victor, playing and dodging and juking for days, running circles around him. And ultimately, they are going to have this slight Uber advantage to work off, as Condom does have the faster respawns. But at what cost? The Russians, they've taken the point already. Kent is still on sniper. He's still got this massive sightline to work off. And the LEGO team, they're in a very sticky situation here, Commander X. And look at that bomb! Oh, what a denial! Oh my god. Was that an air shot?
I'm not sure, but LEGO is still trying to pile in at the back of it, but Shayu on heavy, denying him so well, mows down Zen, mows down Dr. Phil, mows down Sorek. Condom's being chased by Nesh as well, the heavy, but Aizong gets the frag right at the end, they steal it out. It looked like it was going so well for them, but that's all they needed to equalise it, just that one final frag from Aizong, and that'll do, and they can now take it on even grounds.
This is looking rough for LEGO, I'm not going to lie. Mm. A minute has already passed. They do not have Uber to work with. They need to make some plays, but this sniper pickup, Kenzie, is putting in so much work. And here we go. Big bomb forward. Shadowburn taking a lot of damage. Dr. Phil actually picking up Nesh as well. Josh finally gets the Phil, but at the same time, Dr. Phil trades with Shayu. At the same time, Kenzie headshots him just in the nick of time, finishing off Josh as well with a lovely little body shot. Zen finally brings that man down, and it's just Dicker left alive with a 40% Uber to work with. However, this is the first sign of life we've seen in LEGO in a long time so far.
Yeah, really important that Dicker was able to get out at the end there. Keeps the Ubers equal, means effectively this fight can be taken straight away again. And that means, it's because it's Viaduct's all about time, time on the point, it saves them a lot of time instead of having to go for any kind of suicide wave. They're taking that fight straight away now, but it actually looks like it's going to be eyes on. No, Shadowburn somehow gets the frag. Josh is going to chase Shadowburn now.
Oh, such a sticky situation. Yeah, and here we go. They've dropped so many players unnecessarily. They were so far forward. They've lost 3 members of the team now, and they've had to give up this point. As they really, now you're just giving up so much space now. Kenzie is just holding that angle, picks up the frag onto Sorex of all people. Just really just grazes him with that bullet and just brings him down. And now LEGO, they've got the respawns, they've got the buffs, and slowly but surely, Commander X, they're going to look to push right into this.
Yeah, they're coming straight back onto the point here. Don't want to waste any time. They're pressuring Kenzie out really well. Zen's going deep as well. They forced them back into the corner here. And they do have Uber the Russians, but they're not in a position to use it right now. They do get that frag on Josh, which should open it up. They're coming in with the demo man. Now the multi goes, but Dicker drops his demo man. It's now just Nesh with the rest of this Uber. But Shayu's behind. Shayu's get caught in a 1v1 with Sorek. Sorek's all taken down. Now Aizong's chasing, but he's super weak.
Oh my goodness.
Shadowburn tries to find the frag. Shadowburn has been on fire. Dicker just about survived. So much pressure coming
Big
in here.
Big bomb by Zen. just completely shut down. Oh my goodness, this denial by the Russians is absolutely incredible. And this fight is still kicking off. I think Lego holding quite passively. Big one forward by Shio. Can he make anything happen? Eyes on the back lines. Gets a point. Shot on the ticker. Not going to be enough to get the second as Kenzie is the one to finish him out. Nesh finishes up Dr. Phil as well. He's trying to 1v1 against Sorix. Sorix is going to be the winner in that engagement at the end of the day. But Shadowburn, look how deep he is behind enemy lines. Going to be getting off that early spam. Taking a lot of room for his turn to breathe. This man, he's actually unbelievable. I cannot believe he's left us.
I cannot
believe it.
Like in the fight before this one, Shadowburn basically won a 1v1 against the scout on the flank, then won a 1v1 against Josh. Like his DM is just comes to the fore in this map. He's holding that flank by himself. As they're trying to come in, I'm actually going to focus Shadowburn down now, it looks like, trying to stack that flank, and they get a good trade out of it.
Oh my god.
So many frags. Dicker still has the Uber, though, going to pop onto Unlimited, but he's got his one Demoman versus two scouts. Sorex kills the sniper behind him. Dicker and Unlimited in a very difficult situation now. Dicker's going to try and get out main. Unlimited's buying time, and he hits a pipe on Sorex. That might just do enough, and Dicker will get out again, but Lego keeping hold of this point, but it's super close. Only 50 seconds left for Serpents, just about 1 minute and 10 for Lego.
Uber is going to be had on the side of Lego, assuming that they decide to push when they have Uber. This is the Russians, that is. But ultimately, looking at Josh, he's trying to take that 1v1 against Shadowburn. Shadowburn knows the back out of that situation. But at the same time, behind enemy line, Shayu is the one to get this drop onto him. And he actually might pay with his life as well, so that's a 1-for-1 trade. Shayu for the spaceman. Who would have thought it? But here we go, this fight's still kicking off. Kenzie picks up Zen of all people. Unlimited power on absolutely no health at all. He's going to get arrowed up, so he is pretty healthy. And here we go, the Russians. The Uber's going to be popped out. Slight Uber advantage. They can pick up Dicker, is going to be beautiful, and indeed they have. They've collapsed all the way onto the Nesh, has dropped to Dr. Phil as well. So that is a lot of frags, a lot of room to breathe. Shadowburn's going to be trying to make some things happen in the back lines, but ultimately, Lego, they've been looking hot, and now they're looking even hotter. This is looking absolutely incredible. If they were to win a round, it would be now.
Yeah, only 20 seconds left on the clock for Lego. Izon just going to... Kenzie even gets the opening frag onto Izon, but Josh quickly neutralizes that. It's just going to have to be a 5v5 fight now. The Russians need to win this one to stay in the round. Only 10 seconds left. Here comes Dr. Phil fighting the point, putting out as much damage as he can.
Oh,
two frags, Condom and Phil go down. The Russians are on the point. They're cleaning up so many people. Josh is on so little health still in there. Surely he can't get out. That's
five frags
and they didn't lose anyone.
Shadowburn went absolutely nuts that fight. He just literally, Zen tried to go for a last ditch bomb effort, and Shadowburn just said no, and just shot a rocket at him and denied him. He just died. He just, there was no grueling moments where he looked into his eyes and said, you know, can you send my family a message?
Oh,
he just killed it. And this is still kicking off, yeah. Looking at this now, they've actually picked up Unlimited Power. Sorex with the 2k, picked up Kenzie in the end. Here we go, Crit Streak has actually been popped. And Josh on the back lines, Ticker on a sliver of HP. Sorex and Izon doing so much work, destroying the opposition. Shio's going to be doing his darndest, but Dr. Phil picks him up with the pill. And that's it. Finally, a round is taken to the Lego men. 2-1 is the scoreline. They could potentially do this here.
Yeah, it's so close. They're back in it now, but it's still at match point. Only first to three we play on Viaducts here in Europe, so Serpents need to win one of the next two rounds to clinch this opening map in this best of three. And it looks like Kenzie's going to be staying on Sniper once again. Zen swapping up to Counter Sniper, what we thought they would do originally. Both snipers take in that cliff and balcony area. No one's going to find the frag. Both teams just standing off, waiting for their sniper to find that frag. But it's actually Shayu who catches Phil right there. And here comes the Shayu bomb, going deep onto Ivan, but he gets focused down. Both soldiers go down in a blink of an eye, and now they're in a difficult position. They need a frag from Kenzie in this, because Izon's all over them. And there it is onto Condom. Just when they needed it most. But Josh is going deep, and so Sorex. They focus down Kenzie. Nesh is so low. Nesh
they can crush them. They can crush them. Zen got the headshot. Nesh versus the world. Can they do it? Dicta, one of the only men left, and he trades. Josh pays him his life, but the cost is not even nothing for that medic frag. At the end of the day, Condom is going to be up, alive, and healthy, healing his teammates. Going to be with a fat Uber advantage to work off, and they're going to be taking that trade any day of the week. CX, and looking at this now, Shadowburn may try to make some plays happen. He's peeking that corner, trying to get some information for his team. But my goodness, honestly, Lego have pulled it out, and I'm so happy that they're not giving up that easily.
Yeah, they can take this fight straight again away, because the Uber advantage isn't actually that big. So you can see him engaging already, trying to find a way, and Kenzie's going to win that sniper duel onto Zen. He's going to give himself a lot more space. Trying to focus down these scouts now as well, who are all over Unlimited. Josh is following up as well. They do a good job there, but now Josh has surfed his rocket all the way behind. He's using it to get onto the sniper. He's chasing Kenzie, but Kenzie turns around with a no-scope, takes him down. And Josh is, you can see him, he's going so deep to pressure Kenzie out of these fights. But because he has to go so deep, it's difficult if he doesn't get it in the first two rockets. And now we see Lego, Reaper, Chanel.
Oh,
gonna
my
get
goodness, then.
Kenzie straight away.
Oh, wow.
Insta-frag.
Okay. This is it. This is the play. Lego going to be taking this straight to them. They've got an Uber to work with, but so do the Russians. They've lost their advantage now. And here we go. Uber going to be popped out now. Condom still has it. He's going to be popping it straight onto Dr. Phil. Doesn't want to be dropping anyone. Shadowburn on the flank there. Picking up eyes on Sorix at the same time. Picks up their Demoman. So Unlimited Power is going to be going down. Shadowburn on the flank. He's on a 3k. He finally picks up Josh. But at what cost? Dr. Phil versus the world. Can he do this? He's finally trying to get these frags. Shadowburn might actually pick up Condom here. Can he do it? Sorix has finally brought him down. Nesh on no help at all. Eyes on the one to finish him. And here we go. It's still finishing up. Kenzie finally moving to scout. But he's been absolutely outclassed. And now Lego. Oh, Zed. With that final headshot, is really just sealing the deal now. Lego going to be retaking this now. They're going to have a slight Uber advantage to work off. They're going to have their players. They're going to have their heals. And they've got the point.
Yeah, overextension from Serpents right at the end there, chasing those frags unnecessarily. Going to allow Sorix and Eyes on to clean them all up, and Zen getting that last-minute frag on Dicker as he fell out is just the icing on the cake. They have control of the point, the lead in time, and they've got Zen on sniper, and here come the Russian, but a big body shot on Shadowburn's going to deny him. Eyes on's going to finish that one off. Unlimited's in a lot of trouble now as well. Shayu can't get through the flank. Nesh is isolated on the point. Now Shayu's isolated. Lego picking them apart right now. Kenzie needs to hit something. He gets one on Sorix, and that'll help. But they're still outnumbered. They need bigger shots from their sniper now.
What a headshot. Oh my goodness, and here comes Josh on the back line. He's going to be trying to pick up Kenzie, but at the same time, the frags are coming out from his team. Shadowburn, he's defending his sniper pal there with a beautiful rocket. And here comes the attempt now, all the way onto Condom. Hits off one rocket, two rockets onto Dr. Phil, but it's not going to be enough. Zen on sniper now onto that cliff area. Shadowburn going to be putting a lot of pressure onto him. Can he pick up this frag? I don't know if he's going to be able to do it. The collapse is coming out by the Russians. Shadowburn is so deep behind enemy territory. Nesh has picked up eyes on as well. And Lego, they're in a very sticky situation here as Kenshi picks up Zen. Frags coming up for days. The Force comes out by Shayu. What is this man made of? The Russians just turning up where it counts.
Shayu's still running around as well. Takes a long time to die. Gives the rest of his team time to set up. And they have an Uber in tow as well. They need to get the Force out here. You see Josh walking forward. They actually pop quite conservative. You want to try and catch the frag. But Unlimited and Nesh aren't in a great position to chase. Need to be careful not to overextend again here. Nesh is going deep. He gets one, though. He gets Dr. Phil, but Eyeson gets the counter frag. And it's actually worked out pretty well for Lego right now as they pressure Unlimited. Sorix and Eyeson turning it on and crushing them, punishing these overextending Russians. Just Shayu left on the field for Serpent as we see Lego just edge past Serpents in time.
What a complete 180. Seriously, Lego. Now they're going to be the ones holding this advantage. They're going to have a massive Uber advantage, so as long as they don't get forced, as long as the suicide attempts don't come to fruition, we do see Kenzie on sniper slowly but surely peeking that cliffside, going to be trying to get off those hits, but this positioning by Lego, they're not giving any room to breathe at all. Josh on the back line is going to be trying to make something happen. It is going to crater in the end, and that's one frag for them to work off, and the Uber's actually come out, and Dicker, he's in a very sticky situation as Dr. Phil picks up the 2k, Nesh and Kenzie going out, eyes on as well. Shayu with a big bump forward actually picked up Condom there. And this is absolutely incredible. Shadowburn still trying to make something happen for his team. He's going to pick up that health back. He's on 130 HP, but he's against the world pretty much. The entire enemy team just really hounding his down. And he's eventually going to fall. The Russians only just getting their respawners. But at what cost? Lego have just come up as well. And there's 8 seconds left on the clock. They might be able to retake this. But all it's going to take is one big rebush. And here it comes. Lego all the way forward. CX, what are they going to do now?
They're taking the fight, but Shai has pressured them back quite a lot. They actually get a better trade out of it. They're going to stack the point now, but here comes Nesh. Dr. Phil shuts him down. They need to stop Dr. Phil. He's putting out so much damage. Great play from Dr. Phil to open it up. Now it's up to Eyeson and Zen. Shadowburn's going to chase down the sniper frag. Now it's just Eyeson and Condom left in this fight. They still have time to get this Uber, though. 45, just under seconds on the clock. And they're going to come back in with both scouts. It's all about what these scouts can do now. Eisen and Surex on the point. They get it. The Russians need to challenge it. 1 second. Are they going to make it? They get on there just in time.
Oh, my
They're stacking on it. Condom goes down.
Oh, my God.
90% on Dicker. He goes down. The heavy comes out from Shayu. It's just Dr. Phil and Surex. Kenzie wins the 1v1.
What?
30 seconds left.
Left.
Look at the health. Shai's the only one with any health. Aizon's gonna spawn and run straight away for it. Lego just need to cap it.
I feel like you need a sniper in this situation. This heavy, I feel like, is gonna wreck them if they try to push into him. Now, Shayu is in such a defensive positioning. He's already revved up, ready to go. Josh with the big bump forward, gonna be trying to make some plays happen. And here we go. This is the final few moments with 14 seconds on the clock for the Russians. And if they do this, this means they're gonna win game number one. Kenzie on the back lines, and look at this destruction. Unlimited power of the 2K. Shadowbird follows it up with Condom. It's only three men left alive. Big bump forward by Josh, it's not going to be enough. Eyes on one of the only men staff standing, and I think that is it. That is GG. The Russians win it 3-1 for the game number one, I should say map number one of the grand finals of DreamHack Open Qualifiers number four. What a game! Oh my god,
yeah, so much back and forth, so much. The DM Fest, that is obviously, that is Viaducts, but they come out on top and. It sort of all comes back down to that map veto, you know? Like, who wouldn't ban this against Serpent?
Yeah. It was a bit silly. It was very silly, actually. Yeah. Second thoughts, like, why would you not? You know that Kenzie's incredibly capable. Viaduct is an incredible game for it, an incredible sniper. So, I expected them to take one more round, Lego, but Serpent's winning is definitely not a surprise to me. It's all about this next game and how Serpents are gonna handle. Is it Snake or... Well, it is Snake,
yes.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Have you got the logs from this first game? Let's take a look at
it's
them
already
now.
Up. Yeah.
And Shadowburn crushing it. Like,
oh,
you
God.
Can't... What can you
oh,
even
God.
Do against that?
Yeah. 423 damage per minute. We were worried about Kenzie. But Shadowburn, you mentioned halfway through that game, he was absolutely wrecking faces on the flank. Literally taking 2v1s and winning.
Yeah. The Shadowburn of old, like, just three rockets and wins these fights, like, it's ridiculous. You know? It's just crazy.
Oh my goodness. 16 deaths as well on the man. Did he eat a lot of the heals?
No. Heals per minute, 110.
That's ridiculous. It's actually ridiculous. I cannot believe that this guy has moved to Overwatch. The talent on this man to be able to do that as well, because we were making a comment about the scouts potentially, if they're only running one scout they might run into an issue, but God almighty, they destroyed.
It's interesting as well, if you compare, especially looking at Shadowburn stats compared to Zen, you're talking about the roamers and the sort of influence they have, you know, like,
yeah.
Soldier Viaduct is a hard map for soldiers to have an impact on, but when one roamer's making that level of impact and the other is doing that, you can't help but think when it comes to these chaotic fights, you're always going to have the upper hand. And another weird thing is if you look at the assists between men, like, Dick are just involved in a lot more of the fights as opposed to Condom.
Yeah.
Like, Condom did do pretty well. He stayed alive quite a lot of the time, but not really. I don't know. He just never seemed to be involved in the fights at a crucial time.
Yeah. All in all, these logs are just showing the complete story, really, that we may or may not have missed. Lego had a few opportunities to take it, so it was a reasonably close game, but ultimately, you know, there's what they called Serpents? Scorpion? I wanted to call them the Scorpions for a second, and Serpents. Yeah, they come out on top, so.
I'm just trying to find out if the advanced stuff is going to work on for Viaduct.
It kind of does, but it kind of doesn't. Yeah, you can look at
it?
The do it.
I'm going to press some buttons and see what happens.
Yeah, so you can see in the certain parts of the map, obviously most of the fighting is going to be kicking off on the mid, but that's the case with most maps anyway. And you can really see.
Okay.
All right, we're going to be changing it anyway, because apparently it's not showing up. Is this one working?
That one doesn't make sense.
It's all messed up. We're going to skip the logs.
Wait, hold on. PvP kills will still work.
Okay, we're giving up. We're giving up. Give up.
Rip. Error.
Give up on the logs.
Error made. Let me take it down. Sorry about that, stream. Technical issues.
What's crack-a-lacking on the TFTV2 right now?
No spoilers.
Perilous versus Bags. Oh yeah, of course, some people might want to look at it, but...
I can't wait to watch that VOD of 5050. This will obviously, if Perilous do win, that'll be the first prediction I've got right in this season.
Okay, good on you.
Yeah.
That's a controversial opinion as well, that Perilous are going to win against Bagsa.
Waited to the safest one of all to get my predictions right. I predicted publicly to win this tournament as well.
Really?
Yeah.
Even after they got crushed by LEGO?
Yeah.
In the week one?
I thought they would come back, but... Nope, still can't push, so still lost. Anyway.
I have high hopes on LEGO, anyway, to win this. Anyway, this is Snake Water, so it's a bit, kind of a different beast altogether, but again, these mid-fights, they can be very impact-based. Volatile, impact-based by your soldiers, and Shadowburn has proven from that last game that that man can play soldier. Like, there's no denying that. So, do you consider, like, should they be focusing down Shadowburn? How would you play these mid-fights if you were LEGO?
I don't know. I'd be tempted to take the trade with them, essentially. Do you know what I mean? Just to send your soldiers and people aggressive as well, and just take the fight, because we saw quite a lot on Viaducts around that middle point when the cap was being contested. Dr. Phil was quite often getting the best of Unlimited. Like, he wasn't necessarily just like straight up fragging him, but in terms of a point presence and damage Dr. Phil was putting out in comparison, it was much better than Unlimited's.
Yeah.
And if Dr. Phil can initiate that kind of presence again, that can only cap, that will work great for Izon and Sorex, and they will be able to clean up. Like, I think it's better if they just make these fights a mess, because their DM's not too far behind Serpents. And what, I think it's a lot to put in, to put all your eggs into sort of a defensive basket, do you know what I mean? In terms of absorbing everything. I think it's risky, especially with the sort of talent the Serpents players have individually to try and protect your medic from all of this.
Are we going to see Hafikul on the coach role again, or have they just cut him?
Yeah, so Hafikul doesn't appear to be on the server, so they might do a lot better now.
They've cut him as coach. Yeah, maybe he was just telling them the wrong things, like... I don't know.
I think he wasn't actually saying anything. So
you just hear his keyboard just
silent coach
clicking in the background.
But I think this, what we might notice though is just in a more traditional pocket role now, obviously Josh and Shayu will play more traditional pocket roles since it's not Viaduct. And I think in that aspect, Josh will have the ability to dictate the pace, control the pushes much better than Shayu can. I think for Serpents, it has to be the flank players. It has to be those impact players, Shadowburn, Kenzie, Nesh. Like, I think combo-wise, Dr. Phil, Josh, and Condom are going to outclass their Russian counterparts.
Yeah. All right, that's a bold prediction. Well, not necessarily bold. I think I'm probably in agreement with you, to be honest. Hafikul has joined their roster as well, once again, as the coach. So maybe they have confidence in him. Who knows? I don't know. Maybe he's there to stop them from tilting. It's easier from an outside perspective. So it's a nifty little feature, though, this coaching. I like it.
Yeah, it'd be useful. I don't know. I guess because it's the only sort of tournament structure that has this. It's not something many of the teams are used to having or needing.
Yeah. But Sim in the chat, our wonderful man on camera, raises a good point about what's his name? Shadowburn. I was about to say Sideshow for some reason. Shadowburn running the black box and the banner, playing pocket and destroying men.
That was pre-nerf, though.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
I mean, it's not completely ineffective now, but it'll be certainly be interesting to see.
Oh yeah, yeah. I don't know if he's gonna still run it, but yeah, who knows? This game, they have the men in the server. I don't know what they're waiting for. Just chilling around. Eating some dinner, having a few drinks. I don't know. Who knows?
Oh, what do you thinking, man? Are you thinking LEGO are just going to dominate this fight? Traditional 5v5 setup? Or...
I don't think they're going to dominate, but I think they might clinch it. These mid-fights are going to be a bit tricky with the combined aggression from Shadowburn and who else is on Soldier? Shayu. So, yeah, I think it's going to be tricky because the soldiers on the Russians are definitely quite strong, and mids can be quite predetermined by these soldier bombs, depending on the way you want to play the mids. But Snake War is quite formulaic in the way it's played. So, honestly, who knows? It could go either way. I want to hope that LEGO win, simply because we can go to a third map and cast that as well. Even though we've been casting since 4 o'clock for me anyway. Well, 4:30, wasn't it?
Yeah, and that semi-final was just a haze for me, though. I don't remember any of it.
I don't remember it. Just,
you know when you're convinced something definitely happened, but you have no actual memories of it. But we're going live, so let me see if I can remember this one.
All right, well, this is, of course, map number 2. The Serpents in red, the Russian team from the Russia, is generally the country where Russians are from, are going to be rolling out to this mid-fight against the very might of LEGO, and we're going to see if they can clinch this one again. Potentially a 2-round lead, but here we go, already kicking off Zen in the back line. Look at Shadowburn, big bomb forward, going to be getting off that early damage. Straight away, Josh going to be doing his darndest to bring him down, and indeed they have, but look at this aggression coming out by the Russians. Shayu actually brings down Dr. Phil in the end. What a trade by that man. Actually picks up the frag beautifully before falling to Josh, and ultimately they've had to back all the way out, the midpoint already being won by the Russians here.
I was about to say, that's exactly what they wanted. You know, both their soldiers go deep, go down, but they create all the space and set up all of it. And they're going to take this fight straight away. 4 versus 3, but it might be a mistake.
Oh my god.
Sticker takes so much damage.
Oh my god.
Josh is actually going to get popped off on him. Kenzie's in trouble, though. Just about escape somehow. Surely not. Kenzie's just dodging Josh. Josh continues the chase, but Josh has had to go really deep for this now. He's going to try and go behind instead. They lose Shadowbird. They're losing a lot of people here, actually, and Josh is behind them. Nesh is taking this fight, but Josh is just cleaning up behind. Okay. They have to go deal with Josh. But they lost 3 people there, and now Serpents can't move forward with this. If anything, I imagine LEGO might be tempted to throw a player or two in. But instead, they're just going to opt to set up on CP2, make it difficult, and just build that Uber as hard as they can.
They don't want to obviously push in when they don't have this super advantage, because they would get absolutely munched. But here we go, Shy with a big bump forward, going to be trying to make some things happen, and already Shadowburn getting very deep onto that pipe area, going to be trying to create some room for his team, and already Condom only on 80% Uber. He needs to get this, they want to contest this, but the Russians absolutely crushing them, forcing them all the way out. Shadowburn picks up Zen of all people as well, and that's one more frag. Are they looking to replay this? I don't know. Shadowburn is getting very aggressive up in that upper area. He hits up a lovely rocket onto Sorex, and here we go, the Russians want to play this, exchanging the Uber straight away. Condom with the slightly better Uber coming out. Josh is going to be trying to take that fight against Shadowburn. That 1v1 not really working out in his favour. Shadowburn gets off a beautiful little rocket onto him. At the same time, Izon's going to be chasing him down with the help of his scout partner, Zen, trying to put in that damage. But ultimately, LEGO not looking too hot right now. They're still trying to push in through this lobby area. See it.
It's taking a lot of damage, Josh especially, and that's going to have to force them back. And I think a bit of a misplay from Serpents coming in on that. I think they thought more people were closer on this left-hand side, not just for one soldier, so they didn't have too many players to focus with the Uber. But they don't lose too many out of it, and they're able to stabilize. They keep the Ubers equal, but they have a sentry and heavy to contest with on this last point.
And here we go, fight's kicking off already. Kenzie the one to fall, and I think the Russians, they want nothing to do with it. They backed all the way off. That heavy off class is putting so much work, so much denial. Or are they just sacking Kenzie until he can go sniper?
I believe that is the case, I imagine, right now. And you can see, look at LEGO, react, changing their hold instantly. As soon as they see Kenzie go down, they transition to this forward hold. Josh holding close, just to deny Kenzie in that angle. And if you look at where Condom's standing, Kenzie would have to take the ballsiest peek to even get a shot on him.
Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness, Shadowburn just running all the way in, gets off one rocket onto Josh, not going to get the second one. But ultimately, this is such aggressive positioning down by LEGO. They don't want to give any room at all. Josh going to be holding up on that that balcony area. Shadowburn just walking in for free, pretty much. Gets off one rocket, two rocket. Can he hit the third? Indeed he does. He's actually fallen. Dr. Phil with a beautiful little pill. Brings him all the way down, right down to the respawn timer. And here we go. Kenzie falling to absolutely slivers of HP. Sorex is eventually going to fall to unlimited power, however. Zen in the back lines picks up Kenzie. But it dropped a lot of players. 2 down on either side. Shadowburn's just respawned. Not really enough that LEGO can play off, but these defensive off class is still going to be a detriment to the Russians' potential pushing.
I like this play from LEGO, sort of sacking in a couple of people, because they have that Uber and they have that sentry. They can buy so much time that they can just get the respawns in, as long as the trades aren't like horrific. Sorex goes in there, gets caught by Shadowburn, but it's not the end of the world. But what we will see now is they're actually going to pressure Josh off this right-hand side, but in comes Zen with a backup. Dicker goes in, but Shadowburn's separated. He has to hide around the corner from the sentry.
What?
Josh will claim the frag.
They dropped two players.
And Happy Corn Sorex down.
What? What happened
there? They're back now. I don't know, that's weird. Everything's fine now, though. But Kenzie's got loads of space on his left-hand side. Just acres and acres. No one's really pressuring now. Here comes the spam as they move forward once again. But it just seems like a matter of time. Like, surely Kenzie's going to get a shot eventually, you know?
You'd think, yeah. And you'd hope that they'd create the opening that the Russians are so desiring. But still, The scoreline is 0-0 right now as it stands. Lego the ones on the back foot right now, but he's defensive off classes. We do see the engineer building his little nest in the corner there, completely undetected. Shadowburn peeking it wide, peeking that angle, trying to get some damage, trying to spot out where that sentry gun is. He doesn't actually know where it is, I think, right now, but he might have a good idea of it. Dr. Phil picks up Kenzie as he got a little bit too aggressive there in that upper, I believe, upper left area. And is that the pick they want CX to push in off?
Not if Sorix is going to go down straight away, because that just kind of neutralizes it. And Lego doing a really good job of holding, but Serpents aren't giving them an opportunity to turn it into anything more than holding. As Shadowburn goes in
goodness.
Here, two directs onto Josh, but Josh has got a van. Josh goes down, great play from Shadowburn. But in comes Zen trying to get the counter frag. Shadowburn's there again, trying to just force his way in versus everyone.
Stickers
chooses not to Uber, and Limiter's taking the fight as well. And Lego somehow stabilized. I feel like they should have committed to that. I feel like Dicker should have just Ubered Shadowburn and forced a messy trade. A bunch of Lego players around to force the multi on, and then they can try the repush. But everything cools down after that engagement, and both things are reset.
Oh no, that's a terrible sentry position, Izon. I'm going to move that, mate. Yeah, they have spotted that out, and he's going to be trying to put in some work. Actually, it's not too bad, because it is going to stop them from pressuring that corner too much, but they can just corner peek it and spam it out. And that's exactly what they're going to do. Look, it's already down to a third health. I think he needs to move this, but as soon as he moves it, that's going to give an opening that the Russians could potentially play off.
Yeah, we see Kenzie again trying to make that angle. And look, the sentry gun is actually stopping Shadowburn or the sniper peeking on that left-hand side. And because Dr. Phil has the other door stickied, and Zed and Sorix are watching bottom, all these doors are denied. And it's Shai who's going to pay the price trying to get in there. And it's actually really effective. And it's also like, you see Sorix hanging around getting a buff to slur area. It gives Sorix free reign to just keep peeking and see if he can find an opening.
Yeah.
Like without actually too much risk to their last hold. Instead, they're just going to try and come through this left-hand door again. But Josh is going to have so much damage by the end of this game if this keeps going. Because he's just shutting it down. And that sentry gun combined with Josh's spam just makes that door. But Mackenzie's peeked all the way out! He takes the Sean Condom!
Oh my goodness.
Dr. Phil caught napping, not watching that top left, but he gets away with it. Condom stays alive, stays with his Uber, and they get away with it. But they're still in the same position.
This is it.
Last.
Yeah, this is the situation where we're left in, really. I mean, the Serpents, there's so much on the line here for both teams, and they one misplay could potentially translate into momentum, and momentum into rounds and rounds into games. So I can understand the hesitance from these teams now, especially in the grand finals. A lot of damage. This Sentry is doing a lot of denial, but it's just really when they start to like pull out like the gimmicks, like these direct hits. Like I don't know, at what point do you go? Look at this damage onto the Sentry.
It's so good.
So close. It's honestly, every time it's so close to being brought down. He doesn't have any ammo, so now would be the perfect time, but they just don't know.
Yeah.
Josh is doing a wonderful job of defending it, to be fair. He's just literally walking in the way of all of this spam.
Yeah, and he's got a full reset now. He used to build a dispenser, really, Izon.
He's got one. It's just on the other side of the map. Yeah.
Oh, it's going to be a long walk.
Yeah. But this kind of gameplay is what we live for. It's Kenzie waiting for these picks, slowly but surely peeking.
I can just move into a bit of a weird position behind the truck now.
I don't know if I agree.
He's moved back now, and we see Sorix actually on sniper. A Shadowburn once again goes for his continuous 1v1 with the sentry.
Could they not sack in here? If the sentry's in a weird situation.
Wait, Kenzie got Phil? I don't know how. That's going to force them to come in. They've come in through the other side. Zen meets them. The Uber is popped. They get the force out of Condom, and the sentry is still on the right hand side, but it's now only watching one door. It doesn't actually cover the point. Josh is trying to keep Dicker in there, but Kenzie's still finding Ken. Condom's so low, he's going to crater from Shayu. Josh is desperately trying to fight him, fight the sniper, and deny him. Will get the frag. In they come, though. Dick is so low, but
they're still going
to
replay this,
yeah.
Commander X, they want to fight this, and they want to fight it now. Shadowburn's going to be jumping all the way in, taking that high ground. Going to be trying to take this fight against Dr. Phil, but he knows better of it now. He's had second thoughts as they do realise the spawners are just coming up. And once again, left in this fated scenario that we do see, it's still nil 10 minutes in. That was 209 seconds before using that Uber.
Dicker was so close to going down from Sorix there, but they defend him just in time. And now they have a big advantage to work with. 72% against 25%. And this is their opportunity right now. They've worked this, they kept Dicker alive in that scrappy fight. And now they can probably just take this straight in. Like the sentry, the medic, the soldier, all in the same place. If they just take the Uber into them, they can get a lot of damage. But I think they want to go the other side.
Yeah, I think they don't want to really contest into that sentry. It'll just buy a lot of time up and eat a lot of time up. We do see Kensi is going to be trying to get that entry frag that they so wish. The only frag they need. They just need one pick. It doesn't matter who it is, and they can potentially play off this. Josh is just eating all that damage
please
that's
go.
Meant to be for the sentry.
Please go. You have the advantage, please.
Oh my god, the sentry's picked up Shadowburn as well. So they're going to lose their over advantage pretty soon as well. 10%. Made up 95. They're going to have 100 now. Condom already built it all the way up. Shayu is on absolutely no health at all on that left side. He's eaten a nice little trap there by Dr. Phil. But still, this classic scenario that we see. They're so common at Snakewater, and it's really one slip up can mean absolutely everything for either side of these teams.
I can't believe they didn't push. They had such a good advantage. All those players were grouped up as well. And now we're actually going to lose their demo man. Unlimited gets caught out by Josh again, working that right hand side so well with that full heal. It's going to allow Sorix to move up a little bit, but get spammed out. Going to have to get a buff and try again. Again, both teams have Uber. Unlimited respawning now. 60 seconds and it's
until
reset.
Until it's reset, yeah. I think this is the plan, to be honest. Even if LEGO get the opportunity to push out, if they can just reset that mid fight again, this is going to be beautiful for them. I cannot believe we've been in this scenario for so long. But here we are. Kensi's going to be trying to get this frag, and I think this is going to be a last-ditch effort by... They got to anticipate the push now. They've already dropped one player. They have to anticipate this push because there's only 40 seconds remaining on the clock. There's no reason that the Russians would not push off this at all.
Please go. They're going to the other side.
They have to. They're going to have to. And here they go. They're clearing the stickies. They're getting ready to move in. Uber's going to be popped out now onto Shadowburn as they're looking to make these plays. Uber going to be coming out onto Comdom now. Going to be saving Dr. Phil in the nick of time. Shadowburn going to be trying to make some plays happen as he's just really getting forced all the way out. The sightline that he's forced to is not ideal with that sentry. The big bump forward. Trying to pick up Sorix. It's not getting anything done. Two players down on the side of the Russians there. They're not getting anyone at all. 10 seconds remain. Three down now on the side of the Russians. The heavy off class doing its darndest, but Dr. Phil is going to pick him up as well. And this is going to be a reset. We're going to see this mid fight kicking off again.
18 minutes in, we've hit a stalemate. So here we go to middle once again.
Yeah, now I think LEGO are going to be wanting to never be in that scenario again so far in this map. So it would be interesting to see if they play this middle a little bit differently than they did last. The aggression by the Russian soldiers in the first time was absolutely insane and completely detrimental to them losing it. So it's going to be interesting now, CX, as we're rolling out into this fifth mid fight.
Yeah, we see Phil getting there quite a bit ahead of Unlimited, but no real damage advantage so far. Dr. Phil sticking off his own kitchen, going to deny any sort of flanking plays. But here comes Shadowburn up top straight away.
Oh my god.
Josh counters them, but Shai's follow up. Unlimited's moved so far across point. They've got two early frags again. They're pinned into this corner, and Shadowburn's behind. Shadowburn and Shai both on Condom. Condom can't escape, and they absolutely crush them. Six frags for the price of one.
That was ridiculous, to
be
honest.
Back to last. Build a sentry. Yeah. Here we go again.
But they honestly, they've only just got these spawners. Three players just come up. They're going to be capping up second, and they've got a massive Uber advantage. So how do you even defend this in this scenario? They don't have enough time to build the sentry. They might be able to get a heavy off class or something. Potentially a sniper, and indeed, yeah. Izo is going to be your... What's his name? I think I've just called him by the wrong name.
Who?
It is Izo on sniper, isn't it?
Eyes on,
yeah. I call him Eyes on for some reason. But here we go, Uber going to be played straight away into this last Zen, going to be eating the bulk of that damage. He's going to get shot down straight away. A lot of cap time being played, and here comes the conversion by the team, but it's too late. 1-1 makes the scoreline to the side of the Russians. I should have went 1-0, I should say. I'm just losing the will to speak.
Finally
taking this round, almost 15 minutes into this game.
Yeah, it's so weird. They literally stalemated out the first time, and that time they convert their Uber advantage push straight away. Makes you wonder why they didn't go that other time they had Uber advantage on last.
Yeah.
But here we go on mid once again, and LEGO just can't deal with these aggressive soldiers. And we see him line up again. Again, Shadowburn goes behind straight away. Zen was waiting for him, but Shadowburn just skip jumps through. Now Shayu's coming in.
Here we go.
Shadowburn coming.
Big aggression. Condom goes down. Shadowburn with the complete damage already. Only two up on LEGO. Completely destroying them. Unlimited power is getting a little bit cocky there. It's actually fallen to Dr. Phil. And now it's Nesh on the side of Dr. Phil. They are going to be able to pick him up in the end as Kensi and Nesh are going to be cleaning up quite easily. But all in all, that was a scrappy mid fight. That was really scrappy, actually.
Yeah, it's what I was saying before the game. I think they're better off taking that trail. I haven't seen quite what happened, but I think it was Zen who was able to get the frag onto Dicker. And that's crucial, because that means, in reality, even if the scouts cap in a CP2 point, they can be challenged straight away. In fact, the cap won't even come down as the soldiers come flooding out. Kenzie in a lot of trouble. We're actually going to get picked off. And now, LEGO are actually in a position to take a fight not on their own last or a mid-fight. And it looks like they want to move off that one frag straight away. Josh calling for that heal, wants to go in, but that double soldier spam on that door makes it so difficult. And Unlimited's actually stickied off Kitchen, meaning they can't come in that way.
Yeah, they're playing it anyway. Shadowburn has one pick for them. Absolutely beautiful for LEGO now, and they're going to look to play off this any way they can. Nesh has picked up Zen, however, on the back line, trying to 1v1 against Sorex, but at the same time, this fight's kicking off on the midpoint, and they've lost so many players now. LEGO absolutely crumbling under the pressure. Nesh doing a wonderful job behind enemy lines, putting in a lot of damage. Dr. Phil might pay with his life. He does escape just, but Aizom is the one to pay in the end against Kensi. And here we go, LEGO being forced all the way back to last once again.
Yeah, they have Uber, but I imagine someone's going to want to go. We're going to get two of these spawns in time, Sorex and Josh. And the Uber exchange should give eyes on time to spawn as well. So it should be pretty much 6v6 fight. It all comes down to this Uber and what position they find themselves in after the Uber. They lose their Demoman early on, and Kenzie not looking good for Serpents right now. Dicker will just about get away, but they drop three bodies. And now the chase is on. Sorex going underneath already. Shadowburn's waiting though, pounces on him.
Here comes Oh my goodness. Here we go. Picks up the 2k. How do you get that in those scenarios? It shouldn't happen. It goes against what TF2 is about.
You
should be able
looking.
To pick up those kills easily.
Three rockets at any one time. It picks up both scouts, and it just... It doesn't save CP2, but it means... They can no longer, push the middle, and now Kenzie's got a lot of space
actually,
to work with.
He headshotted Josh there and completely forced him all the way back, so LEGO... LEGO are not feeling hot in the slightest right now. As it stands, they're in such a disastrous position. They got 13 minutes, 30 seconds on the clock left. If they don't start to bring it back a little bit here, if Happy Cool doesn't start to pull up his bootstraps and start wrangling the beasts here into a formation, if you like, and start to get LEGO back into order, you know, this is looking rough. But, I mean, we have 100% Uber on both sides. They're going to be waiting for these picks. And there's one of them. Dr. Phil, the first one to fall, and they're going to be playing this Uber straight to win CX.
Yeah, they're powering their way through. Josh goes down as well, and that's two picks. And now we see Shayu just chasing them out. Shadowburn's behind already. They do get it down, but they still lose two people. Now Shayu's all over Condom. Condom's dancing around, but he dances back into the stickies. That's a full wipe. Dr. Phil on the respawn, but they're already on last. Dr. Phil has to put everyone he's juggled into the air. Oh, Kenzie! Just with the cherry on top of that push, and Serpents take a 2-0 lead. Just under 30 minutes left. And if Serpents win this map, they win the tournament. LEGO need to come back right now in a big way.
They're crushing them. They are absolutely crushing them. They need to make some plays happen. And here we are. This is the third mid-fight. If there was ever a time for them to do it, now would be the time. Happy Cool really needs to pull out his coaching mind and pull out all the tricks that he's saved up all of his years of TF2 to try and round up LEGO and try and get them this victory that they so... need and want. But here we go. The mid-fight's kicking off straight away. Kenzie dropping to absolutely no have at all. Josh with a big bomb forward. Going to be completely died off. Zen also coming in, trying to get into distraction plays, but at the same time on the back lines. Unlimited power picks up Dr. Phil before Dr. Phil, picks up a frag onto Shadowburn with a lovely little pill. And LEGO are crushing this mid-fight. Dick is going to fall as well. And this is just Shayu left alive. He's going to try to pick up that health pack. He's going to try and basically one man against the
wall. Josh
spotted him. One shot, two shot. Kenny a condom. Oh my god, that was too close. Too close for comfort. LEGO almost threw it completely away again.
They get away with it though, and that could be the piece of luck they need to turn this game around. As Condom holds onto the Uber bravely after Josh just doesn't check both corners. And now they have an Uber advantage to push into last with. 11 and a half minutes left. There's still plenty of time to work with. We see Kenzie holding really far forward, but he might get caught out. Easy opening frag as they want to push in here. They're going to Uber through the door. All over Unlimited now. Force him down. The level one sentry does
nothing. This is what I needed. Look at this pressure by Dr. Phil. Look at these stickies pushing themselves all the way in. Big bump forward. Shio actually picks up the 2k with Alva Shadowburn, but it's not enough. 2-1 makes the scoreline. 11 minutes remain. And LEGO, they're bringing this back slowly but surely.
I was about to say, it looked for a second like Shio and Shadowburn did a lot of work, but it was just... It was just so much advantage for LEGO. Like, too many players, too much health, that it didn't matter. And in the end, LEGO pull one round back. A very quick response to go in two rounds down. As we go into this next mid, and they won their last mid. The first one they did on Snake Water. And again, we see both teams posturing up. Josh goes aggressive early on again. Shayu denies him with the airshot. Shadowburn trying to follow him, but the
goodness.
Scout pounce. And Nesh is actually the first one.
Making another one. There's three down already. Commander X. Oh, Oh my god, Allegro are doing this. They've already picked up 4 kills. Dicka just manages to escape with 30 HP. I don't know if he got a sword there, but he's going to be chasing them down. Shadowburn's doing this darkness to keep them off. Sorex is completely ignoring Dicka, and that might be the misplay there. I think if he caught up to him, he might be able to frag him. No, they're not going to get him there. He's too far out.
They're going to get the spawn, though. 80% on Dicka, but they should be able to get it in time before it comes in. 9 minutes left, and if the Serpents could do it with a Lego-style 10-minute hold now on this last.
But yeah, they're going to be Ubering straight in. Going to be popped out by the Russians as well. This Heavy and Sentry doing a lot of work, and Lego, it looks like they want nothing to do with it, Commander. It's just backing all the way out.
Yeah, they just got the Ubers out of the way early on. I'm not quite sure, because they don't seem to be following it up at all. I don't know if they realised they couldn't really get much of a multi off, so chose just to reset the situation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they do have a lot of time to work with. Like, they have, 9 minutes or 9.5 minutes to get this one round. But obviously, putting your tournament life in a golden cap scenario is a bit of a gamble, isn't it? It all comes down to that mid, and these mids have gone, either way. And now we see they're moving forward right now, trying to move before they have Uber, but Shadowburn denying that side, going to pick up Josh. Wow.
Okay.
Shadowburn giving Josh a taste of his own medicine after Shadowburn got denied so many times on the reverse side of him. And now Shadowburn's hiding for Sorex as well. Wants to find it, does get him. Shadowburn just finding picks, hitting Eren everywhere. But they don't want to risk it, they're not going to try and push out. Because the frags didn't come at the same time, they were kind of staggered. It just makes it riskier, as one of the respawns will arrive while the fight is going on. And instead, I imagine it's actually given them an opportunity to off-class, as we see Sorex make the switch up to Sniper.
An interesting little tidbit of information for you all. There's no way this will get reset back into a mid-fight, because there's only 8 minutes. There's 2 seconds ahead, so we are going to see them. Even if the game does go all the way onto last, Lego will lose. So, there you go.
Have you seen Shai's dispenser and teleporter position in front of that shutter door with the aim just to deny, essentially? Yeah. We see Josh actually coming kind of deep right now. Kenzie's going to dome him. And Shadowburn's going to pressure out the sniper, and he's presumably going to get an arrow from his medic shortly. Shadowburn just holding it by himself right now, effectively. Going to call for more. He's just getting arrows from Dicka constantly, holding that right hand side by himself.
Yeah. I'm surprised more teams don't do that with the teleporter and dispenser, to be honest, because even if it's just 1 second that it buys you, it's really good. I suppose most teams aren't on last long enough to set up that kind of hold, but yeah, I don't know.
I know. It looks like Serpents are in here for the long run, When there's 1,000 euros on the line, you're willing to defend last for 8 minutes.
Yeah.
And that's the dispenser going down, trying to spam their way in against the sentry. They get the teleporter as well. Points being farmed, and they're trying to spam down the heavy, just trying to get an opening. And actually, Sorex has peeked all the way up, but Dick is just in spawn.
Oh, he's just missed a shot.
Sorex has got a lot of room actually on this top hand side, and Unlimited's taken a lot. Was that an arrow? No, he's just squeezed away on low health. Sorex will get a frag. And this defense is in tatters right now.
Yeah. This heavy off class is not working out for them. Uber's going to be popped out now. Dicka finally popping it in the end. But he's dropped a lot of players. Kenzie actually picks up Sorex in the end, so that's no sniper for them. So this is still most likely winnable for the Russians, as they don't really have the players to do it. Josh is going to do his darndest, jumping right into the air. But Nesh on the heavy has done so much to deny him. Zen's probably going to pay with his life. Indeed, he does. He finally trades, however, with Shayu. But it's all for naught, as it's just Dr. Phil. He's trying to escape with his life on 60 HP at the same time. Yeah, Shadowburn. The complete addiction from him to completely destroy him and any hopes and dreams he had of getting out of that alive.
Shadowburn's on the prowl once again as well, peeking onto mid, just seeing where these players are, trying to see if he can catch anyone going into a hiding spot. Sees everyone in front of those, so if they want, they can maybe try and just walk in a straight into mid. No demo man as of yet, Lego, and he's respawning, so they won't have stickies for a sec. But it looks like Lego actually want to take this fight straight away. 6 minutes left, and because of how slow the Snake Water can move, Lego needs to be conscious of time here. Shadowburn forcing Zen out, holding the ground. Actually, was that Shai? I don't know. Either way, Shadowburn's just dancing around this Saurian, buying time. And Lego now equal Uber still, and they have an opportunity. Still, 5 minutes 40 seconds left. They need a round to stay in this tournament, to stay in this Grand Finals.
Anything at all would be what they need right now. Any pick, if they can get at least one frag, It'll be beautiful for them. No off class has been run by either of these teams. And I think they just looked at... Are they pushing through this green area of the Uber? What are they playing at? Are they just going to... They might go for like a soldier sack here, yeah. So Josh is getting very aggressive. They spotted out these stickies, but ultimately time is against the LEGO guys and they gotta make the most of it now. 5 minutes remaining. This is tricky for them.
Yeah.
There's one sack. That's the force. That was the force.
Oh, did he? Nice. How are they going to be able to move forward off of that? LEGO just want them to push, begging them to come in and Shai.
Oh my goodness.
Shai takes the bait and now they're going to move forward. Ideally, they'd want to walk in, but there's stickies on this door. They're going to go window instead. They're bypassing all
this
the stickies.
This is completely doable for them.
Yeah, they've given up CP2 right now, so they're going to get CP2 for free and use his Uber on last. Shadowburn's out there in cheese by himself, though. Should be able to get out. Josh is chasing. Shadowburn gets away with it. And they will be six up in this last defense. They have a heavy. They're slowly filling up at level one sentry. They're getting that entry fight onto Josh.
Yeah. Uber going to be popped in straight away. Izon going to be getting his mitts, his grubby mitts onto Nesh. Can he bring him down? The damage is definitely there. It's Dr. Phil is the one to get the frag. And at the end of the day, they need to play this, and they need to play this carefully. That level one sentry doing a lot of denial. Dr. Phil's going to try and play the point, but if it's all for naught, they've dropped so many players. How? How do they beef this time and time again? 4 minutes remain. They cannot make mistakes now. This cannot be happening, LEGO. If you want to have any chance now, you need to be doing this cleanly and concisely.
Yeah, they missed it. I can't believe it. Like, they've had these chances right now, and now it's all in the hands of the Serpents having that 50% Uber advantage. I'm not sure if they're even going to push. Actually, they are going to push. No fear from Serpents. Not playing for time anymore. Shai gets headshot as he comes in, but they're still forcing it in. But Starks is behind on the back cap. This has caused three players to go back to deal with him. They should be able to deal with Surex, and they do, but it's pulled him apart. And Izon gets the frag onto Dicker.
Oh my god.
The condom goes down as well straight away to Unlimited.
How
and now the Russians are DMing it. They're
How
just DMing
they?
It.
I don't understand. They had three players behind enemy lines and they were still losing that engagement. And it's only Dr. Phil alive. LEGO have been completely shut down. Shadowburn just absolutely destroying. He's just completely jumping on him. Sorix and Zen getting those forward spawns. But Shadowburn, he might even make it out alive there. Zen just escapes with a nick of HP. And ultimately, 3 minutes remain on the clock. LEGO are in a very tight corner.
It's really all or nothing for LEGO right now. Like, they need to take this fight and they need to win it. 2 minutes, 50 seconds left, one round down, playing for their lives in this tournament. Against this Russian mixed team.
Yeah. This is honestly ridiculous. Because, I suppose, like, of all the teams as well, this is the reason it's quite heartbreaking, is because out of all the teams that would go, LEGO are probably guaranteed to go, but the prize money would go so far to getting them there. But at the end of the day, that's not the way the tournament is running. Here we go, Josh with a big bump forward, going to be picking up Shadowburn. That's a lovely pick, but at the same time, Kenzie and Nesh picking up those two frags, and that's absolutely lovely for them. Shai is eventually going to fall to Sorax as he does just pepper him down across the map. But really, they got to play the time now, and they got to play it well. 2 minutes, 10 seconds remaining, Commander X, and not really showing any signs of life.
They need to go. What are they doing? Just go, LEGO, go. Waiting for spawns. It was a 4v4 situation. I know they don't have forward spawns, but this is, you know, it's getting to the time where you just have to take these risks. And now it's given them time to set up. And you see Shadowburn on that high ground. They're going to try and come from this low door, but Shadowburn's above him. He could do so much damage. They're going to Uber through instead. They should be able to get Shadowburn, but how much more can they get? The Ubers pops out onto Shai now. They need to somehow scatter. They're going to focus down Zen. They've actually got some people behind.
They can make
this a really messy fight.
This could be doable. If they converge on them now, it's going to be absolutely brilliant. Sorex already balls deep inside Dicker. Going to be trying to get that frag. And at the same time, Josh on the back lines is going to pick him up. Unlimited power hits up one pipe. Gets a beautiful rock onto Nesh. But finally, Unlimited power is going to bring down Josh in the end. And it's just Dr. Phil versus Unlimited power. Shadowburn going to be jumping in to help his mate. And I think, is that it?
Surely I don't know. They're running out of time. 1 minute left, and they have no one up. They're not in a position to go over. They're losing CP2. They need to go fight the CP2, and Shadowburn's hiding. The scouts spot him out, but he might have bought some time. They have to go for this now. They get Shadowburn down. They have to go. They have to go hard. Get two. They're going to get Kenzie as well, surely. They need to move so
they
quickly.
They need to be rapid on this now. 45 seconds remaining on the clock. And look at the position now from the Serpents. They're so passive. They're basically just going to give up that midpoint and see where it can lead them. But they need to play this so quickly. They literally just need to leave one scout on mid and pressure everyone forward. I don't know if they're going to be able to deny these forwards.
It's crits as well from them.
They haven't even capped!
30 seconds. From Condom.
Okay, this is crucial now. Yeah, 25 seconds remaining. They need to basically just roll deep all the way
to
last.
Yeah,
straight away. They need to go all the way in.
Wait,
if they can do
point.
This, is going to be the comeback of the century. Crit Scree going to be come down. Dr. Phil is off one, is off two. Shadowburn the Human is going to be popped out now. But the Sentry and Nesh doing so much work. Sorit's on the back line. Big bump forward. Can they do anything? I think this is over. Nah, it's just Ainzo. And it's just Condom. He taunts on the point, but it's all for naught. 2-1. LEGO lose in two maps, and it's finally the grand final winners are going to be the Serpents, this Russian mixed team coming out of nowhere, Shadowburn coming out of retirement temporarily, and they're the winners of the 1,000 euros.
Wow. Just wow.
Just wow.
Yeah.
Honestly. What is... That's just ridiculous, honestly, how that even happens. They're decent players, though. This is the thing. They're very decent players on this Russian team, so I'm not surprised, but it's just... It's insane how much of an impact Shadowburn can have on the entire game, as well as Kenzie.
Yeah. Let me just load the logs now as we're looking at them. Yeah, absolutely bizarre. Absolutely bizarre. The way they did it as well, like, attacking last for so long. It looked like, you know, like, when Reason did it, and they held last for so long, then just rolled them back. But they just couldn't break it.
Yeah, it's honestly, all in all, what do you even say about these logs? I mean, Josh was putting in a lot of work there, 347 damage per minute. Shadowburn and Shayu also putting in a fair amount of work. Ultimately, can we compare the damage and kills as well?
I think, obviously, Josh's damage is padded a little bit, you know, when they were holding last for 10 minutes and Josh was just shooting rockets at groups of players around the corner constantly. Still impressive though, but it's weird, it was such an even fight, really, in so many ways.
Yeah, if we could get up the overall damage done, I don't know what page that is on.
Team stats, there we go.
Yeah, yeah. So you can see, it's not even that really clinched on the side of the Serpents, like, kills-wise, they're not even that much ahead, are they? Beyond that, like seven kills, is that correct?
Yeah.
My math's completely off.
Yeah, that's seven. That's how numbers work.
There's a difference of seven. All right, good. It's good to know that I've passed year nine math.
But it's those opening three middles. Now, Serpents want all of them. They gain that two-round lead.
Yeah.
And then they just held on, essentially. Like, that last round being almost 11 minutes. Just holding on for 11 minutes with a one-round lead. Much of it on last as well. But they just dug in. Dug deep. And they got it.
They did indeed. I cannot believe it's over in that, like, anticlimactic setting. However, we have been casting since... How long now? It's been...
5:30 CET, so 5 hours?
5 hours, yeah. Only a short break for leftover pizza and water, but much needed.
Any more stats before we go? Map percentage?
I don't know if we want to do... Yeah, let's get up some of these so we can look at these frag percentage. The frag percentage by zone.
All online, yeah.
Yeah.
Lots of it in LEGO's own half, you know, and they were pinned in for so long to begin with.
Yeah, these mid-fights really crushed them overall. Like, absolutely destroying them. You can see as well, relative frags by zone. Mid-fight's actually being led by Unlimited Power, so the Demoman having quite a big impact by that, but ultimately, I think what the stats don't show is, and what we saw in-game, was that the soldiers were absolutely just creating so much space for the team to play off. Shadowburn and Shio, just unbelievable stuff.
Yeah, I think maybe if we look at the PvP kills, like player on player, who got the most? Maybe it shows nothing as well.
Yeah, it was an incredibly even game. It went really quite down to the wire in a lot of aspects, but it was just, these stats are going to be a bit weird and inflated by that last hold for 10 minutes. So, you know, it is going to be a bit strange. But ultimately, what more can you really say from logs when we've just watched a game like that? Are we going to be getting interviews in?
I don't know. I don't know if LEGO will want to come. The Russians won't come.
Get Shadow Burner.
Kappa Pride, Shadowburn interview, Kappa Pride. Yeah.
Is that? I think that's it, though, isn't it? That would be the. That's pretty much the final DreamHack qualifier concluded, overall. Yeah, we're not going to do any interviews as well. So yeah, that'll be the final DreamHack qualifier. The next one will be, how many weeks is it until DreamHack? It's like four, isn't it?
Let's go with four. That sounds,
Yeah, four sounds
about
about
4 weeks.
right.
Yeah.
So 4 weeks until the actual DreamHack event is going to kick off, and that's going to be held in DreamHack Summer in Jönköping. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly.
It's Jönköping, but nice try.
Jönköping, thanks. I do try. But yeah, it's going to be really interesting to watch. You're going to be seeing, I'd imagine, we haven't had confirmation yet, but I still imagine it's going to be Nameless, Perilous, Publiclear, and Lego going to be attending still, unless the Russian stack decide to get visas at the last minute.
We'll wait and see. I believe tournament admin Sideshow will be sorting all this out, and there'll be some kind of news post confirming and clarifying everything and what to expect at DreamHack Summer. But as it stands now, the Russians walk away with 1,000 euros, come out of nowhere, beat the established LEGO team, who were pretty much favourites given all the other teams in the brackets. Also knocking out various other Prem teams like Happy Farmers and such on their way. Yeah, just really great showing. Great showing from them, from the individuals, and they'll get a nice tidy money reward for it.
Yeah, and it's really good that these tournaments are being ran as well. I mean, TF2 is definitely one of the games that deserves it, and you know, no matter which team the money goes to, at the end of the day, they did earn it fair and square. And it was really nice to cast these games as well at DreamHack. I really enjoyed it. I had a good time. I mean, the only one I didn't cast was the third one. I pretty much casted everything. It's been really, actually, really a good road, a good show. A long journey, Commander X, a long
Yeah.
journey.
So I think on that note, I think we should end it. I believe the other game's actually finished as well.
Yeah.
So much TFT today between the Oz Fortress Grand Finals, this tournament, the Premiership fixture. But it's all come to an end now. It's Monday again tomorrow.
Oh, not Monday.
But yeah, so thanks for watching, everyone. Thank you to Bren and Sim for sticking with me for what, 5 hours, we say, just over 5 hours.
It's been around that, yeah.
Yeah. Obviously, congratulations to Serpents. Look out for that news post confirming all the DreamHack details from Sideshow slash one of the other many writers we have. And stay tuned, because obviously it's week two of ETFWL coming up next week. So Team Fortress TV will be bringing you all of that one way or another. So stay tuned and look out for the VODs of tonight's game, and obviously the ETFWL match over on TFTV2 will be put up at some point in the near future. Anything else to add, Bren?
Final shout out to my nan, if she's still watching.
I don't
I
think
don't
she
know if
stayed
she
for all
is.
5 hours.
Are you sure? I don't know. You don't know my nan. And Sim says shout out to you say it, Commander X, before I make a
Equally.
mockery of myself. Yeah, there we go.
Shout out to
So
Equally
yeah.
from Sim.
All right. Is that it? I think we're done. See you
Yeah.
guys. Thanks for tuning in.
Good night, guys.